We are in the book of the nature. We are in the middle of the biggest trees of the planet, the giant. We are in California, in Sequoia Park. This is the book of the nature. All these trees are our teachers, our spiritual teachers. If we take a time, we feel their energy, their peace. In 1 second, they calm our mind. In 1 second, they change our neurochemical system. In 1 second, we become a tree. We are a tree. Our feet are our roots. And we can feel the energy from the earth going inside us, goes straight to the sky. When we are here, we are reconnected from the earth to the sky. We are stressed, we suffer because we are disconnected, because we forget our roots. We forget our feet. When we are in a wood, in any wood, we feel the force of the trees. So the first teaching of the trees, this is the calm. Calming energy that they give immediately. They don't give tips. They have no ego. They don't talk. They share their energy. We are grounded. So immediately they teach us that when we calm our mind, we are reconnected from the earth to the sky. And for this first teaching that they offer to us, we can sing to say thank you to the giant. Thank you to the people of the trees. We can sing from the ground to the sky.
Yeah, you way, you way.
When we are in the middle of the biggest trees of the planet, you see this giant. He teach to each of us humility. We are nothing. Nothing compared to the giant. This tree is like a person. I love when in native tradition we don't say the tree. We don't consider a tree like a thing, but we consider a tree like a person. And you see, wow, this person is a giant, one of the biggest trees of our planet. He is a giant. We forget all time our humility. We want to be a giant. A giant of blah blah, a giant of ego. We are nothing. We are nothing. You see, compared to this tree, oh, we are nothing. So he teaches to us that humility, this is the door to develop our spiritual awareness. What does it mean? Most of time we confuse, we think our spiritual awareness is to enter in a sort of mystical state of mind. Not at all. The real awareness is when we stop to talk about awareness, when we calm our mind, when we feel how this tree is connected, that we feel how this tree helps us to calm our mind. And when we calm our mind, we are reconnected. We feel the eternity. We feel the beauty of the silence. We feel God. We feel there is something beyond that we can see. There is something beyond our intelligence, beyond our thought, our belief, our concept. We are ridiculous. You see, this tree, he doesn't talk, he doesn't think, but he is present. He doesn't need to talk about to be present. He is present. This is also the real meaning of meditation. We don't calm the mind when we say to someone, take a deep breath, be calm. We calm the mind of someone when we tune the energy of the person with no words, like this tree. This tree doesn't talk, but it tune immediately our energy in a calming vibration. And immediately we feel better. When we are tuned in a calming energy. Immediately we upgrade in our brain the serotonin, the dopamine, the hormone of the well-being. And immediately we feel this sensation in our cells, because every cell of our body is connected to our cortex, to our brain. This is the real meaning of meditation. This is not a technique. This is not a tip. This is not a concentration. We don't need to be concentrated. An authentic meditation. This is exactly the moment when we don't try to stop our emotion, but when we see our emotion are moving slowly. What a teacher, what a spiritual master. Let's meditate like a tree. We close our eyes. And we breathe in the force of this tree, the eternity of this tree. We keep our breath. And we exhale his eternity in our body. We breathe in his eternity. Keep his eternity. Exhale his eternity. And there is this amazing moment. We realize we don't meditate like a tree. The tree is meditating inside us. We feel his energies inside us. And calm our mind and reconnect our body, our soul, our mind from the earth to the sky. We feel we become a tree. When we are in Sequoia Park, in the middle of the biggest trees of the planet, the giant trees, the gigantic trees, we realize how they are interconnected. All the trees are interconnected. A wood, it's a village with a lot of people, a lot of giant. And every tree is interconnected with the roots under the ground. They are all interconnected. And in science, we know today that when one of the tree is sick, the other tree, they organize a way to to bring savia to him and to irrigate his roots, to cure him. Yes, there is a communication between the trees. Each of them take care of each of them. It is not a poetic picture. This is what we see now in science. All is interconnected. This big tree is force. Take care of the other trees. What a teaching for us. We suffer because we don't take care enough. When we are in the middle of this village, the city of the biggest trees of the world, we realize how all is interconnected. And if a tree lost his interconnection with the other tree, he die. We understand that we need to be more and more connected, each of us. How can we be more connected? Let's ask the question to our teacher. Hey, giant, how can we be more connected to someone, to God? Have you listened his answer? He has replied by silence, by his calming energy. When we calm our mind, we are reconnected to everyone. We are never alone, never sad. We are healthy. What a teaching. Instead of to talk and to talk for nothing, and to have an extreme way to sophisticate our thought. You see this giant, his answer, silence, calm. The more we calm our mind, the more we are reconnected to everyone, to every tree, every person that we met. Let's ask another question to this tree. According you, giant, what is the most important in this world when our world is very challenging? You listen his answer. He reply with his calming energy. Yes, he say to each of us, the most important, especially in our time, when in our time we are disconnected, the more we create genius communication, the more we are disconnected. He reply, the most important, this is to calm our mind. When we calm our mind, we survive. in our world. And when we say, but how can we calm our mind? His answer is beautiful. He says, come here. Come to me. Feel my calming energy. Feel how I calm. How can I cure your body, your emotion? When someone calm, talk to us, or when we talk quietly to someone, we do the same thing that he is doing for us at this moment. So everyone, we have the responsibility to calm everyone. Like this tree calm everyone. Anyone can come here in Sequoia Park. And you can come with a lot of stress, anxiety, fears. You arrive here, poof. He cures you in 1 second. Because his calming energy reconnects ourselves to God, to our nature. Like him, we are made of eternity. We are made of elements, made of atoms. And the last day of our life, we will go back to the eternity. So, when we talk quietly to someone, immediately, we help the person. And we don't need to talk, just we need to share our calming energy. This is a real healer. He never say, I am healer. He say nothing. Just he share is calming energy. Calmness is our nature. This is the only thing that we need. We need to receive calming energy. We need to share with everyone our calming energy. This is like that we can survive, that we can live, that we can have a better world. You see, when our mind is calm, we live in a better world immediately. So, to finish, we can sing for him. It can be your offering.
Oh, you Omani Pemeom. Omani Pemeom. Omani Pemeom. Omani.
Money.